Hello everyone, welcome back to AeroHub and welcome to the series of lectures in flight mechanics. In this lecture, we will discuss about the introductory part of flight mechanics and also we will discuss about aerostatics. Basically, flight mechanics is a subject is concerned with flight mechanics. Is a study of motion of an object in atmosphere. This is the standard definition for flight mechanics, and flight mechanics is basically consist of, we can classify this subject into two, that is flight mechanics, is concerned with mainly two divisions. First one is airplane performance or aircraft performance, and second section is, or second division is, flight stability and control. Okay, these are the two subdivisions of flight mechanics. In performance, we will calculate the performance characteristics of an aircraft. For example, we will find out the speed, we'll find out the range, we'll find out the endurance, we'll find out the climb angle, rate of climb, then we'll find out turn rate, bank angle. Okay, these are the terms related to flight performance and we will discuss that in the upcoming lectures. And don't confuse regarding this range, endurance, climb angle. These are relatively new terms for you. So I will discuss about this term later in this lecture. And flight stability and control is mainly concerned with, it is nothing but handling quality of an aircraft. Handling quality of an aircraft under the influence of external or internal forces. This is called flight stability and control. In this stability control, we will derive relations between stability derivatives and you will find out the location for CG, that is center of gravity of an airplane, and you will derive the relation between static margin, neutral margin, and also we will find out the limit of an aircraft up to which CG can be moved. Okay, so this is one of the very complex subject in aeronautical or aerospace engineering. So we will discuss about stability and control in the later half of this lecture, and we will discuss performance also in the upcoming lectures. And now in this lecture we will discuss the introductory part, that is we will discuss about the mainly the principles of flight, and also we will discuss about aerostatics. There are mainly three principles of flight. They are principles of flight. I think you have studied this thing in your elements of aeronautics. I think you are studying, just brush up the fundamentals. First method is float on air by being lighter. Okay, it is called aerostat, and I think you have studied about classification of aircraft. In classification of aircraft, we have two main subdivision. First one is aerodyne, second one is aerostat. Aerodyne is nothing but heavier than air aircraft, and aerostat is nothing but lighter than air aircraft. Okay, so float on our air by being lighter, in the sense we are using gases like helium, hydrogen. It is basically concerned with air balloons, hot air balloons, or airships. Second case is push air down. This is for aerodynes, that is basically the aircraft we are using, aerodyne. Third principle is push something else down. Push something else down. Here the third principle of flight is mainly concerned with the application or the principle of flight of rockets. In rockets we have something called propellants, and we are burning the propellants to generate the thrust as well as the lift. Okay, so these are the three principles of flight: float on air by being lighter, that is aerostat, and push air down, that for aerodyne, and push something else down, that's for rockets. Now in this lecture we will discuss about the performance parameter or performance of aerostat. That is basically we have gas balloons. In aerostat we have gas balloons, and we have hot air balloons. Okay, these are the two types of aerostats we are discussing, and we will find out the performance of this particular types of balloon. In gas balloons we will be using hydrogen and helium. Okay, these are the gases which are lighter than air. And in hot air balloon we will be using the same air, and we will increase the temperature of the air to produce the lift. Okay, so in this hot air balloon we will increase the temperature of air, will increase the temperature of air to produce lift. Okay, so in this lecture we will see which balloon produces more amount of lift, either hot air balloon or gas balloon. Okay, which one will be the best to produce a certain amount of lift. Okay, now to study the basics of aerostatics we need to know about the gas law as well as equation of state. Okay, so I think you are aware about the gas law. Gas law is, so we are going to aerostatics. Okay, so our next heading is aerostatics. These are basic things. Okay, this I think you are aware about the all these things. Gas law, you are aware about gas law, that is PV, P into V is equal to N RT. Okay, I will write R in this manner, N RT. Okay, where P is the pressure, that is in Pascal. V is the volume, that is in meter cube. And N is the number of moles, and R is, this is different R. Okay, I written like this. Okay, R is the universal gas constant. Universal gas constant, and it is expressed in joule per mole Kelvin. Okay, now T is the temperature, that will be in Kelvin. Temperature, this is in Kelvin. Okay, I put this as equation number one. Okay, now I have to derive the equation of state. To derive equation of state, I will use this space. Okay, so you are aware about density. Density is equal to, density is denoted by the letter rho. Rho is equal to mass per volume. Okay, and from this equation number one, we have PV, we have volume term. So volume is equal to mass by rho. I'll put as equation number two. Okay, and now we have to relate this N is nothing but number of moles. Okay, so I can write molecular mass, that is mass is equal to the number of moles N into capital M. Okay, where N is the number of moles and capital M is nothing but molar mass. Okay, molar mass, that is nothing but mass of a single mole. Okay, molar mass is nothing but mass of one specific, mass of one specific mole. Okay, this is the molar mass. That M is nothing but the mass and N is number of moles, and number of moles into multiplied by molar mass gives the mass of the gas. Okay, so from in equation one we have the term N. Okay, so N I can write from this equation as N is equal to the mass divided by molar mass, equation number three. Okay, so I'll substitute equation number two and equation number three in equation number one. Okay, so substituting 2 and 3 in equation number one, so I'll be getting P instead of V, I substitute as M into M divided by rho is equal to, instead of N I'll write as M by capital M, where M is the molecular, M is the mass and capital M is the molar mass. R is the universal gas constant into T. So I can cancel out M from both sides. So I can write P by rho is equal to R by M into T. Okay, so I can write the final equations as P is equal to rho RT. Okay, I put as equation number 4. Okay, see, I have written R in a different way here. Here the R is in a different way, and this R is equal to universal gas constant by molar mass, and this one is nothing but your specific gas constant. Okay, this is nothing but the specific gas constant. So P is equal to rho RT, where rho is the density, R is the specific gas constant, T is the temperature, and R is equal to 287 joule per kilogram Kelvin for air. Okay, so R is equal to, we have a value, R is equal to 287 joule per kilogram Kelvin. This is for the value of R for air. Okay, now we will see about Archimedes buoyancy principle. Okay, we will see more about the aerostatics. Now we will see about Archimedes buoyancy principle. Archimedes buoyancy principle. Okay, so we have a balloon here. Imagine this is a balloon. Okay, and I am filling this balloon by some amount of air. Okay, I am completely filling the balloon by air. Okay, so the weight of this balloon will be nothing but mg, that is the mass of air inside the balloon. Okay, and to keep this balloon in air, okay, we have to generate a certain amount of lift. That will be force FL. Okay, to keep the balloon in air, there should be a certain amount of lift that should be generated. Okay, so according to Archimedes principle, the force, the total force has to be same as the weight of the volume of air. Okay, so to keep the balloon in air, the force, that is FL, that is the lift force, should be equal to the weight. Okay, so I can write FL is equal to, mass is in terms of density, it will be rho of air into the volume of the balloon into gravity, gravitational constant. Okay, this will be the equation to keep the balloon in air. Okay, so now instead of this is filled with air, now I'll select one more balloon. I'll take one more balloon here, one more balloon. Instead of air, I'll fill this balloon with a certain gas. Okay, that is a gas which will be lighter than air. Okay, to produce a certain amount of lift and to keep the balloon in air and to keep the continuous motion, we have to fill the balloon with a gas which is lighter than air. Okay, that is the first principle of aerostatics. So in here also you'll be having a certain amount of weight and we have a certain amount of lift load or force of lift. Okay, here the equation will become FL is equal to, and outside this balloon we have air. Okay, so we will write, we have a balloon with a gas which is lighter than air. So the equation for lift or the force produced to keep the balloon in air becomes rho of air volume into g minus rho of gas into volume into g. This is the equation because instead of air we are filling with the gas. Okay, so the equation will be just neglecting the value of rho vg, that is total volume inside the total amount of total mass inside the balloon and with the this equation, first equation. Okay, so just you understand that whenever we are having a balloon which is filled with a gas, we have to reduce the equation, we have to subtract from the equation of lift when the balloon is filled with air. So finally I can write FL is equal to this rho air vg, that is I will take this one outside, rho air v into g 1 minus rho of gas by rho of air, and I put as equation number 1. Okay, equation number one. Okay, so and this equation is called the general equation for balloons. Okay, this is the general equations for balloon. Equation one is the general equation for balloons. Okay, now we will see about gas balloons as well as hot air balloons. Now we will see more about gas balloon. In the case of gas balloon, I have already discussed in the lecture, we have a balloon in which we are filling with a gas which is lighter than air. Okay, we have a balloon in which the gas is lighter than that of air. Therefore, I will write this medium as 1 and the outside medium as 2. Okay, therefore, in the case, the pressure inside and pressure outside will be constant. Okay, almost constant. It's not exactly constant. We'll assume that the pressure inside the balloon and pressure outside the balloon are almost same. Okay, that's the assumptions here. So we'll assume it is not exactly constant, but we have, it will be like a certain amount of change will be there, but we have to assume that the pressure inside, that is P1, is equal to P2. Okay, so this is P1, 1 for inside and 2 is for outside. So by the equation of state is nothing but P is equal to rho into R into T, where R is nothing but specific gas constant, and this R is specific gas constant is equal to this one universal gas constant divided by the molar mass. So I will write P1 is equal to P2. So I can write rho 1 into, this is universal gas constant, R divided by M1, that's a molar mass of gas inside the balloon, into T1 is equal to rho 2 into R by M2. This universal gas constant is always constant for each and every gas. Okay, into T2. Okay, so I got this equation. Now I have the equation FL from the previous step. I have derived FL is equal to rho of air into V into G, 1 minus rho of gas by rho of air. Okay, this was the equation for general equation for balloons. Okay, so rho of gas is here rho 1 and rho of air will be rho 2. So I can write this equation as FL is equal to rho of air into V into G, 1 minus rho 1 by rho 2. Okay, rho 1 for gas, rho 2 for the air. Okay, so I can write rho 2 here also, no need of that. Now, from this equation, I have to derive the relation for rho 1 by rho 2. So rho 1 by rho 2 will be equal to, I can cancel out the universal gas constant from both sides. So I can write rho 1 by rho 2 is equal to T2 by T1 into M1 by M2. Okay, so I can write this equation as T2 by T1 is equal into M1 by M2. Okay, so rho 1 by rho 2 is equal to T2 by T1 into M1 by M2. This put as equation number 2. Okay, this we have to use for hot air balloon also. Now, if the temperature is maintained constant, that is, we are not giving any additional, where we are not heating up the air inside the gas balloon, we are not going to do that. If T is constant, we are not going to heat this gas inside the balloon. So I can write rho 1 by rho 2 is equal to M1 by M2. What is M1 here? M1 is nothing but the molar mass of gas inside, and M2 is the molar mass of air. Okay, so I can write the equation, the general equations as FL is equal to rho of air into V into G into 1 minus M1 by M2. Okay, and put as equation number 3, and this M1 is the molar mass of air inside, gas inside, and M2 is for air. Basically, the value of M for air is 28 gram per mole, and the value of M for hydrogen is 2 gram per mole, and for helium it is 4 gram per mole. Okay, this is the value for molar mass for air, hydrogen and helium. Okay, basically we are using helium comparing to hydrogen, because hydrogen, it is difficult to store and it is having reaction with the air also. So basically we are not using hydrogen because of the storing capability of hydrogen is very difficult, and we'll be using helium instead of hydrogen. So in the equation number 3, I'll substitute a value of M of helium and M of air. Okay, we are using mostly helium air balloons compared to hydrogen because of the capability of storage as well as the cost. Okay, so FL is equal to rho of air into V into G 1 minus M1. M1 will be the molar mass of air inside, gas inside. So we are using helium, so it will be 4, and for air it is 28. It is 28.6 exactly, and taking as 28. So I will be writing, FL is equal to rho of air VG. If I solve, I will be getting 28. It will be 4 by 20, it will be 1 by 7. So I will be getting 6 by 7. Okay. If I am solving this equation, that is 4 by 28 will be 1 by 7. Okay. It will be 6 by 7. So this is the lift generated by a gas balloon. Okay. That is FL is equal to rho of air VG into 6 by 7. This is the lift generated by a helium balloon. Okay, not gas balloon, helium balloon exactly. Okay, now we will discuss about hot air balloon, and we will find out how much is the temperature we have to rise, how much amount of temperature we have to give to the gas to produce same amount of lift as helium balloons. I repeat, we have hot air balloon and we are using same air in the balloon inside and outside, and we have to increase the temperature of air inside the balloon to produce certain amount of lift. Okay, and we will see the amount of temperature we have to increase to produce the same amount of lift as the helium balloon. Okay, now we will discuss about hot air balloon. Hot air balloon. And in this case, we are using the same air inside the balloon. We will use the same air here. Okay. This is 1 and this is 2. We will use the same air. And we have to increase the temperature to produce a certain amount of lift here. Okay. And we have the general equation for balloon. That is FL is equal to rho of air into volume of the balloon into gravity into 1 minus rho of gas divided by rho of air. Okay, this is the general equation of lift for a balloon. Okay, now in the previous step, that is for gas balloon, we have derived that rho 1 by rho 2 is equal to T2 by T1 into M1 by M2. Okay, we have derived this relation in the previous gas balloon topic. Okay, now rho 1 is nothing but the density of gas inside the balloon, and rho 2 is nothing but density of the air outside. Okay, density of the medium outside. Okay, here in this case for hot air balloon we are using the same air inside the balloon, so m1 by m2 will be equal to 1. The molar mass ratio will be equal to 1. Okay, now I will substitute rho 1 by rho 2 as T2 by T1. So I will write the equation FL is equal to rho of air V into G, 1 minus rho of gas by rho of air become T2 by T1. M1 by M2 is 1 here. So I can write this equation as T2 by T1. And T2 is nothing but the temperature of the gas outside, and T1 is the temperature of the gas inside. Okay, so I can write this equations as FL is equal to rho of air V into G. I'll write 1 minus, I'll put the temperature of the gas outside T2 as capital T and T1 as T plus delta T. Okay, I'll put T2 is equal to T and T1 is equal to T plus delta T, because delta T is nothing but the increase in temperature. Okay, we have the same temperature of the gas outside as capital T, and we have to increase the temperature to T plus delta T. Okay, in the case of hot air balloon, we have to increase the temperature from T to T plus delta T. Okay, now FL will be equal to rho of air. After simplification, I can get delta T by T plus delta T. Okay, if I am multiplying here, I will be getting delta T by T plus delta T, and this is equation number 5, and this is the equation for hot air balloon. Okay, now we have the equation number 4. By equation number 4, we have the lift equation for lift for helium, that is for helium balloon. Rho of air V into G, we have 6 by 7. Okay, we have derived in the previous case. And if you compare this equation number 4 and equation number 5, I can write delta T by T plus delta T is equal to 6 by 7. Okay, that means what is delta T here? The increment in temperature. T plus delta T. So I can write this one as 6 divided by 1 plus 6. Okay, I can write 6 by 7 as 6 divided by 1 plus 6. That is, we have to increase 6 times the temperature of outside medium to get the same lift as of helium balloon. Okay, I'll repeat. We got delta T by T plus delta T as 6 by 7. I can write 6 by 7 as 6 divided by 1 plus 6. And this denotes that to achieve a lift of helium balloon, we have to increase the temperature inside the balloon 6 times that of the outside temperature. Okay, so we have to increase 6 times temperature outside to obtain same amount of lift as helium balloon. Okay, so the hot air balloon temperature should be 6 times the outside temperature to achieve the same amount of lift as helium balloon. Okay, so in the next lecture we will discuss about standard atmosphere, and we will discuss what is the importance of standard atmosphere and what is the requirement of standard atmosphere, and we will derive the equations for pressure and density for a standard atmosphere, and we will also see the and we'll also learn how to estimate the temperature at a certain height from the surface of the earth or from the sea level. Okay, so thank you for listening this lecture. Take care.